Sports to the Bone family. What's up, what's up, what's up, my viewers and subscribers? Welcome back to the channel. Alright, my peeps, so I have an update for you guys as it relates to how the warm-up game between West Indies and Zimbabwe is going so far. So at the close of play on day two, it's probably safe to say that Captain Brathwaite is happy with the work that his team, you know, would have put in so far. I'm gonna go through the scorecard, but before we do that, just to remind you, this evening I am going to be live at 6 p.m. around about 5 p.m. Jamaica time thereabouts. So just make sure you check in and come and let us know what you are thinking as it relates to this tour of Zimbabwe. All right, so batting first, the West Indies, they were able to put together 517 for 8. Yes, 517 for 8 at the batting an entire day, and probably can say the better part of day two. So 517 for 8. Captain Craig Brathwaite standing tall, as I reported yesterday, getting 116 of 169 with 10 fours in that knock. Tejnar and Chandapur getting 45, just missing out on that half century. Rayman Reef at 25, Nkrumah Banner 3, Blackwood 17, Kyle Mayers 46. Now the guys that were at the crease at the end of day two, Devon Thomas and Joshua Da Silva, they were able to go on to get significant scores. You understand? Joshua Da Silva, he got a century, so he got 100 off 149 and retired hurt. Devon Thomas had 49, so barely missing out on that half century. We also had Rustan Chase coming down the order, played a very attacking innings, you know, was in the mix of things, getting 87 from 93. And that knock, he was able to get 9 fours and 2 sixes under his belt. So a strike rate of 93. Jason Hola, he wasn't able to get much. He got 4 from 6. You know, 4 from 6. Alzari Joseph got 11 from 14. So that is how it ended up, my viewers and subscribers, with Rustan Chase remaining not out on 87. So 518 for 8 is where we stopped. And the Zimbabwe batsmen, they were able to get a chance to bat before the close of play. And you know, they didn't get off to a good start. They are actually 52 for 5, you know, trying to have a little comeback. They lost quite a few early wickets, but they were able to see it out until the close of play. I think they actually missed some of the time, you know, had to leave the field because of I think I saw some lightning at one point in time. I think it was shortly after tea. I am sure they weren't off the field for tea based on the hours. So I think it was because of the lightning. So, you know, they ended on 52 for 5. So tomorrow is the final day. West Indies will be looking to bowl them out quickly and probably put them back in again so the bowlers can get an opportunity to bowl some more. In terms of the wicket takers for us, Alzari Joseph, he has picked up 2 wickets, 2 for 12. Couple of other bowlers got wickets. Jason Hola picking up 1 wicket for 2 runs from his 4 overs. Kyle Mayers, he got 1 for Mayers got 1 and it 1-1. It was actually a maiden from his 1 over. Shannon Gabriel bowling 4 overs, giving away 17 runs, picking up 1 wicket there. So, you know, Gudikish Moti had 1.3 overs without taking any wicket. So definitely hoping that the guys will be able to go to bowl them out early tomorrow and tomorrow morning, and hopefully we will get an opportunity to have a bowl at them again. You know, this is not a lot of overs for the bowlers. As I said, Roach getting 7, Alzari getting 4, Shannon Gabriel getting 4 overs in, Kyle Mayers getting 1, Hola getting 4, and Gudikish Moti getting 1.3. So we are hoping that you know, the guys will be able to get some more overs in. I mean, if they don't bowl out the side quickly, then at least they will be able to get some overs in. If they bowl them out quickly, then we put them back in and continue to bowl. 500 and odd runs is enough runs at the top order batsmen. They got the opportunity to bat. You understand? Can say it's a pitch that it wasn't doing much. It was a bit flat. They could hang out on the back foot and do their thing. So it was up to the top order and the middle order batsmen to get in and get themselves some runs. So we need the bowlers to get an opportunity to bowl. So the likes of Jason Holder, Nkrumah, Bonner and Blackwood, who didn't bat for too long, you know, they and probably Raymond Reefer. Well, he had 70 deliveries. Those guys will probably have to try and catch their form in the opening test, because 500 and odd runs inside 1.5 day is good enough for the batting unit. So we are looking forward to seeing the bowlers going out there and getting some work in. Just to add, this sort of pitch, probably it's going to be a different surface. You know, the spinners might need to get some overs in, because I am thinking that, you know, the surface that they're going to prepare for the first test match will be a spin friendly one. So, you know, we probably need to get Moti and the other guys bowling some more overs. I didn't actually see the all of it when we were bowling, but from what I saw, I'm not too sure if Shannon Gabriel is 100% fit. I am thinking this is a good opportunity. You know, this would have been a good opportunity for him to have a run out, so they can look at him. We don't want to carry any passenger, you know, as I always say. Shannon Gabriel, a fit and firing Shannon Gabriel, is I always have time for him in the team. Bows at good pace, willing to work, you understand. But if he is not fit, you might pick him, and then you have to have a batsman bowling halfway through a test match because he's out. So, you know, tomorrow morning will be a good opportunity to get some more overs in out of him and take a look at how he's holding up. As I said, if he looks good, if he's feeling good, we'll probably play him in that first test match and hope he gets some wickets, get some overs in, probably shut him down, allow him to recuperate throughout the second test match, and then we take him to South Africa. But we're not carrying any passenger to South Africa. If he's not fully fit, then we don't want him. So yeah, that is pretty much how the guys are doing, my viewers and subscribers. Zimbabwe already losing 5 wicket for under 60 runs. The West Indians getting over 500 runs. Not to celebrate or to jump for joy or anything, but as I always say, doesn't matter who you are playing, you know, it's about staying out there and getting the runs and not finding stupid ways to get out. It's good to see that Brathwaite, Chase and Da Silva and all of these guys that got starts were able to go out there and get some runs under their belt. So gonna continue to keep a close eye on things, my peeps, and by tomorrow I will give you guys an update as it relates to how it would have all ended. So yeah, gonna leave it right there for now, my peeps. Remember to join us live this evening at 6 p.m. as we take a look at quite a few sporting stories currently going on around the world. Big up on yourself, my peeps. I will touch base later on.